Still going strong after 20 years. Rock band Jethro Tull in Nighttime.
They'll never make it in a million years.
I was just absolutely struck by them. They just made such an enormous impact on me.
I heard Living in the Past on Radio Caroline one day and bought a couple of albums and was hooked.
Especially when we came to doing Living in the Past, I knew it was bound to get airplay, bound to get that rush of sales in the first week or so that would get it into the charts and then get it more airplay and get a Top of the Pops and so on and so forth. If you're saying to me, did I hear it and say, wow, that's a number one or whatever, I mean, I shouldn't think I did. I don't think I thought in those terms.
Hello, I'm Anne Nightingale. Have you ever wondered why it is that some bands, having had initial success, then disappear almost as quickly as they arrive, whereas others manage to sustain that success and also a very loyal band of followers, like Jethro Tull? It's amazing to think they've been going for 20 years, and the band themselves didn't think they were going to last. They didn't even get off to a very good start. The label on their first record said Jethro Tull.
Chrysalis Records really only came into existence because of Jethro Tull. We might have come into existence with another group. I mean, it's difficult to say what might have happened if, but Chrysalis Records came into existence because we couldn't get Jethro Tull a record deal other than with MGM Records, who printed their name wrong on the label and wouldn't pay £50 advance for them.
I started a booking agency with a partner called Chris Wright. And in the very early days, what our area of specialization was blues groups. And at that was a sort of beginning of a whole movement, you know, that sort of spawned Led Zeppelin and Jethro Tull and a lot of other people. But when we started, there were just like half a dozen bands, Fleetwood Mac and Chicken Shack and we were one of the agencies specializing in that. And it was a growing thing and we couldn't get enough bands.
Monday morning, the phone rang, and you always go in Monday mornings and you wonder how the weekends have gone with all the different groups you've supplied to places around the country. So I picked up the phone, and it was the promoter from one of the Jethro Tull stroke Bag of Blues dates. And he said, great band you sent me on Friday. I said, oh, you know, whew, that's a relief, you know, their first ever date. And he was actually named by a chap that worked for us at the time called Dave Robson, who was working for us as a booker. So neither Terry Ellis nor myself can take credit for that.
One, two, three, four.